I believe that it is the responsibility of each person on this planet to strive to be the very best that they can be. As Gandhi said, you must be the change that you want to see in this world. I believe this, and so I work to completely eradicate youth violence, poor education, discrimination, and inequality. This is not easy, and it's truly impossible to do without the help of others to accomplish. But Dr. King, Huey Newton, Malcolm X, and Reverend Sharpton realized that one person standing up for what they truly believe in can truly change millions. Oh, yeah. My point is simple. Don't be afraid to try something different. I've had a lot of people tell me that I couldn't do something because of my age. Right. Follow the dream within you, just like Dr. King did. You know, it hurts me to know that mothers are afraid to pick up the newspapers for fear of what the latest headlines might bring. I myself witnessed daily teens handcuffed, face down on the curb. I look with despair and wonder why my peers strayed from the path of success. Finally, I ask, what are adults waiting for? Right. You see, adults are waiting for another Dr. King, Huey Newton, or Malcolm X. That special somebody to just show up. But what if there isn't anyone else? Right. What if it's up to us? I pledge to be one of the voices of my generation, as I refuse to listen to music that did not lift up my people or lift up my spirit. The shows I would watch would have to have a positive message. Needless to say, I haven't listened to much music or watched much TV. But consider this, an almost unthinkable scenario, a world without violence, where no child is abused, no wife battered, no friend raped, and no father gunned down. We can't even think of it. Almost the very thought eludes our grasp. Why is this? Why can't we shake off violence? Is it our cynicism, a failure of our imagination where we can't even think of it, thus unable to dream it? I don't have the answer, but I do know that the vision is the ability to see the invisible, and I have that vision. I encourage each and every one of you to get involved in the community, definitely young people. I started when I was 9 years old. Like they said in my introduction, when I was 9 years old, my friend came to me and she told me what she was going through at home. And ever since then, I felt like I needed to do something. I feel like as her best friend, I had to be the voice of those who thought they had no voice, who felt like they couldn't speak out. So I soon wrote a play. The play was based on a true story about my friends and what she went through at home. And I've had so many young girls coming up to me telling me, well, you told my story. Thank you so much. How many of you all are familiar with Stone Mountain, Georgia? In Stone Mountain, there are no recreation centers for young people to go to. So when young people get out of school, they tend to get in a lot of trouble. They don't have anywhere to go and they get bored. So my peers turn to violence as the answer. We soon, me and a couple of my friends were tired of the violence in Stone Mountain, so we had a sit-in. And 50 kids came out and we slept outside on Memorial Drive for the entire weekend, and adults did not show up. The news and media did not show up to hear what we had to say about the violence going on in our community. So I called Reverend Al Sharpton live on his radio show. I was 10 years old at the time. And I said, look, Reverend Sharpton, you're an activist. You need to do something. We're here. We invited the adults and we invited the media and nobody showed up. What are you going to do? And I know that I kind of had him in the hot seat, because what is this man going to tell this 10-year-old girl who is trying to shake off violence in their community? Right. Mm-hmm. Now, what can he say? So he soon had his National Action Network Atlanta chapter come out and support us that day, quite actually. And ever since then, I've just been working with the National Action Network. I see a lot of familiar faces, Mr. Pellegrino, Mr. Grant Gant. They're wonderful activists in the community as well. I couldn't leave this podium without saying that. And who've supported me for a really long time. And I just want to encourage all you young people that you don't have to wait to be great. You can truly change the world now. Yeah. Just like Dr. King, because that wasn't Dr. King. That wasn't just Dr. King's movement. That was the young people's movement. It was the young people that started that movement. And without those young people, Dr. King would honestly not be who he was in history. So thank you all very much, and it was a pleasure speaking to each and every one of you all today, and good luck to all of you all.